many times you worked very hard with no results. Those who were in NCSS and MSF, maybe you know that you write papers, you draw all these nice models, you go and do presentation, you go and convince people, and then 2 months later, after all the hard work, you realize that actually we can't do this because we don't have enough funds. Yeah, we just got to shelve this. Okay? And these things are, they are not like acute, you know, they come in suddenly like valley experiences. This is chronic. Every day you will begin to see that these things happen. Okay? I learned several lessons over this, but I think this person summed it up the best for us. This comment, we just came back from UK about a month back to see this person called Comet Russell. He's a key guy in doing asset-based community development. So we were sharing with him some of the difficulties that we face. And at one point, he just looked at me in the face and said, Chun. They like to call like Chun Yak, then Chun Na. We have to stop blaming others and start creating space for ourselves. And when he said that, I said, wow, hey, actually correct. Because every time we try to wait for everything to be available before we want to do it. But what he's saying is this, don't find excuses. There is a room for you somewhere and somehow. Go for that space first. Okay? And that really reminded me not to wait for stars to align. Okay, you continue to make space. One of the key things that I learned in the past was this. When stars haven't aligned, you still have to continue doing work, right? And you start to have all these drawer proposals. Huh? No money, right? Never mind. Someday the gold mine and the diamond mine will personify before you, but be ready for it. Because if you are not ready for it, you're still waiting for the stars to align, you got no proposal, you are gone. Just now, I shared with you valley experiences and obstacles. Dark nights of the soul are very real. One very senior practitioner came to Harvey Street in London. Harvey Street is a very, very well-known place for therapy. Okay, if you watch what's that show called? The King George had a show about his speech therapy, right? He actually went to Harvey Street to seek consultation. Okay, so he came to Harvey Street for his sabbatical. We met up and he talked and we conversed on this point. The dark souls of the night are very real. And we will always struggle in a very, very tangible way at different points in our life. I shared with you the experiences. And one of the key things is this, the propensity when you are alone is to give in. So I learned that you never do this alone. You are not special forces. We are not inclined to function on our own because on our own, our minds play games. Okay, so pressing on in the face of obstacles and when you're going through valley experiences is to recognize that you cannot do this alone. So there are people who will be there, who will be able to guide you along. One of them is Vilain, right? Then the beautiful lady below is Tina. We always need to speak to people who will help us gain alternative perspective. I shared with you that there were twice that I nearly quit NCSS. Actually, the resignation letter already sent out already. Actually, Vilain already see the resignation letter because she was CEO then. But she talked to me, Tina talked to me, some other people talked to me and say, is this really the thing that you are going for, you want to do or not? If it is okay, we release you, that's fine. But if it is not, you are doing it because of emotional reasons, right? Hold on to it, don't go first. And I said, but I'm not going to stay here because I'm functioning on 50%. But what was said to me was very, very loving. He said, your 50% is good enough for now. And I think we all need to hear that sometimes. We don't function at 100% all the time, we go crazy. But we need to hear that, well, 50% for now, for a short period of time, is good enough. And I think that calibrated my posture because I was on the rebellion. When you are down, when you are depressed, when you are frustrated, you just want to say, I'm just going to hack it and I'm going to go. But that day when I spoke to, and on many occasions when I spoke to them, I said, actually my heart is not right. I'm just trying to see if I can spark the organization and I'm just going to leave for good. But you know, organizations don't need us to stay because the next day things will go on as normal. Okay?